Blog Talk Radio.
For good eating and stay beating a path to the network with the best you rap will hook you up fast. They keep it crispy with the 411 and eating you right, chopping it up, dishing it out. It's tasting good, but don't bite. For recipes and sublime and info fresh off the vine. They keep you GMO free, cause be you all what you eat. Now if you too busy chewing on the FAT fat wag, tune into the F to the O to the O to D food rap. Listen to the kitchen on the show with the utmost. We need me and Shawna G, your fly MC chef hoes.
Food rap.
It's time to eat better. I know you feel the pressure. Can I get a yes, yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
For the hot show on the block, from the street to the hood. Keep it locked. Fun food rappers talk. Never tasted so good.
Oh, yeah, delicious. Pizzas, hamburgers, and french fries. Oh, yeah. All the fast food I can eat. Oh, no, I can't have it. Oh, no. I'm hungry. I hear my stomach growling. It's food rap.
That's it.
Hey.
What's up, everybody?
What's up? Today is January 8th, 2014. I'm Nina Marcalle.
And I'm Shawna Glover.
And we're the hosts of Food Rap. Talk never tasted so good.
That's right.
And, of course, you've noticed that we're broadcasting on a new day and time, which is Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Yes.
And we're absolutely loving that.
Mm-hmm.
We're extremely excited because it's the beginning of the year.
I'm ready. Yeah, I got my resolution.
It's the beginning of the year, and we have all of these cool things that we're going to be doing this year. We have a new segment that we're going to be introducing tonight.
Yep.
And we'll talk more about that a little bit later on.
Mm-hmm.
We're also going to be having chefs on our show this year. We have a couple of people scheduled. That's going to be really exciting. We have someone scheduled for next week.
Yep.
And we're going to have contests, and everything is going to be more participatory, and we invite you to share your recipes.
And let me just say, the segments that we have come up for this year are really dedicated to our listeners, and it's about saving money and what we can do to help you, you know, provide for your families.
That's
or
right.
Eat better, or, you know, we just want to be here, be a resource for you guys, and that's what it's all about for 2014.
Right, that's right. And the recipes mm-hmm. are going to be like healthy and economical, which is mm-hmm. great in this economy the way things are going. So.
Absolutely, yes.
Yeah, so I'm really, really excited about having had Kevin Moore on last week, and we can't wait to have him again because he's still going through his transformation, and
mm-hmm.
he said he needs 20 pounds to go. So we were really excited to have him last week and look forward to having him in the future. That was a great show.
Yes, and
really
he's
inspirational.
So informed too, and he just, I learned some stuff from him, so I loved having him.
He was an amazing, amazing guest.
Yes, he was.
I do want to point out that today, believe it or not, you know, I've been looking at this food calendar that's really cool. And today is English Toffee Day.
Okay.
I don't know what that means.
What do you do on English Toffee?
I have no idea what you do on English Toffee Day.
Eat English toffee, I guess.
Perhaps.
Okay.
Anyway, so today's special on the menu is Waste Not, Making the Most of Leftovers, mm-hmm. which actually we are dedicating to our wonderful producer, Tylon Washington, because mm-hmm. you know, he and I, and actually you two, we have an issue with how much food is wasted in the United States.
Mm-hmm.
Drives us bananas.
Yes.
And you know what? Rather than throw that food out or ignore it and leave it in the fridge, we figured, you know, you can repurpose a lot of that food and make a totally delicious, interesting meal with it.
That's right.
So we're going to be talking about that all day. It's going to be really, really interesting. And today's show is sponsored by On the Move Sounds, inspired by Mumia Abu-Jamal.
Mm-hmm.
Really
phenomenal CD.
Phenomenal CD.
Yes,
we have
every week.
You know what I'm saying? We have The Hard Wash. We have
Abiodun Oliwoli, who is from The Last Poets. That's
amazing.
You can't get better than that.
Letitia Devine.
Public Enemy.
We have Khalil Khan on here.
That's right. Our very own Nana Soul.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, Maya Azucena, she's out traveling the world,
Immortal Technique.
Yes. All these people have phenomenal backgrounds. They're great performers. They're great politically.
They're really positive, inspirational.
They are. And to get them all on one CD is a real treat. So you guys have to.
And it's actually two CDs.
It is. It's two CDs.
Two CDs.
And we have Mumia himself thanking the artist on the CD.
And you can get this CD, this amazing CD, exclusively at bwmovingimages.com.
Yes.
The number to call, and we really want you to participate tonight. We want you to share your repurposed leftover recipes with us. Give, you know, us some ideas and give our listeners some ideas at 646-929-1521.
Yep.
So, Shawna Glover.
Yes.
Why are you doing food rap?
Well, it's really, I want to give a quick story about someone I spoke to today who was just telling me how much they liked the show, how much they learned when listening to our show. And this is why I'm doing it, because I want to inform people out there. I want to give them the information that they might not necessarily have, because not everyone's out there doing research on this stuff. So, I mean, that's why I'm doing this show. What about you?
Well, I'm also doing the show for that. I like to share, like, information as I find it out. Like, I do a lot of researching. I've been doing that for years, and it's just seemed to make sense. You know, even though initially I didn't want to do it, it seems to make sense to have a show and share with a broader audience rather than people that I just meet on the street. So yeah. I just love sharing and inspiring people to change their diets and just informing them, educating them.
Yeah. That's why we're here.
That's right. So Chop It Up is up next.
That's right. All right. Chop It Up. So basically every week, what we do with Chop It Up is break down food labels for you. It's very important to know what you're putting in your mouth, and that's the whole purpose of this segment, to translate certain words that none of us can pronounce to our listeners. So what do you have for us today, Nina?
Well, basically, when you can't pronounce it, you know, that's clearly an issue. But basically what I decided to do is explain a little bit more why we do Chop It Up, and then you're going to give an example of what our Chop It Up segment is.
Oh, great idea.
Okay, so basically, I actually found several articles, but I found this really interesting one from Reader's Digest Health, Diet, and Weight Loss. And basically what it is like talking about how most households are on a food budget, and as a result of that, people are buying a lot of processed foods.
Okay, yep.
And they're not getting as many wholesome foods.
Yeah.
And the problem with that is there are so many additives in these processed foods, and a lot of this food is stripped of its nutrients. They do things like add high fructose corn syrup, salt.
Fillers, right?
Yeah, MSG. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's cellulose, which is wood pulp.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there are all kinds of things that are a really big risk to your health. And basically, the nutrients that you need to help your heart and to help, you know, the antioxidants are no longer there because of all of the processing of the food.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of things like, what else? Artificial flavors.
Yes.
Natural flavors, which we know is not necessarily natural.
Right.
You know, factory created fats that are not necessarily healthy. Colorings, chemicals, and, you know, bad fats. Refined grains, high amounts of sodium, MSG, which we have discussed.
Yes.
So basically, we're teaching you how to discern what's good and what's not.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, Shawna is going to give us an example of a Chop It Up segment. So what do you have today?
Okay, so interestingly enough, I wanted to, I was shopping and I wanted to, one of the recipes that I wanted to try out, called for a broth, right? So of course I naturally said, okay, I'll go look for a vegetable broth. So we all know about those little cubes that you buy. And I opted for this option because it was cheaper. It was only 99 cents, as opposed to like going to the organic aisle and spending whatever $5-6 to get like the vegetable broth. And I made the mistake of rushing and picking it up and not looking at the ingredients. I said, this is a vegetable broth. This is what I need. I need something that doesn't have any, you know, animal product in it. And when I brought it home, I noticed that it had MSG in it. So I said, you know, this is, you know, it was very high in sodium.
Monosodium glutamate.
Yeah, it was terrible. So I said, and I used it for the recipe only because it's all I had. But I said, you know, there has to be a better way to do this. So I went and I went in search of figuring out how to do your own vegetable broth. And it's actually extremely easy. You know, it's all about reduce, reuse, recycle. You know what I mean?
Yes, I like that, because that's what the show's all about today.
That's what it's all about. And all you have to do is take about 8 cups of water And use your vegetable scraps. Maybe save them in a baggie in the refrigerator. When you're cutting up that onion and you have the ends, when you're chopping up celery and you're not using all of the celery stalk.
That's a great idea.
Carrots, your shavings from the carrots or the ends of the carrots. All those scraps can be used to make a really good vegetable broth.
That's
and
a
healthy.
Great way. That's a great
way
to repurpose your vegetables.
That's
I love it.
Exactly. And, you know, it's, you know, you're not wasting, because all that stuff goes in the garbage. If you're not, I know when I do my onion ends, all that stuff goes in the garbage. And you can even use like the onion skin, because it will help give the broth a nice color. So, throw it into a baggie, put it in the fridge until you're ready to use it. And I'm going to put, there's like a video that shows you how to do it. So I'm going to put all that information. I got it off of a really great blog online. I'll put all that information
on our Facebook
page.
That's such a great idea. I love that. And I've never done that before. That is awesome.
I didn't even know you could do that.
I never thought about it. It never occurred to
me.
So. That's great.
All right. So next up on the menu is the ABCs of food.
All right, so the ABCs of food, one of our most informative, fact-filled segments is the ABCs of food. And basically what that is for those of you who don't know what it is, it's like we usually go in alphabetical order, and we're right back at the beginning. We're up to the letter C, and what we do is we pick a food that starts with, this week, the letter C, and we talk about its nutritional value. So what do you have this week?
Okay, so I actually just had these this week, and I thought it'd be a great thing to talk about because this is like the sister to kale, which is collard greens, or the brother. The sister,
I
the brother.
Love collard greens. Oh,
so
my
of course,
goodness
you
gracious.
Know, I grew up on collard greens in the traditional, I guess, southern fashion, which is, you know, you boil them with, like, you know, turkey meat if you don't have pork, or, you know, pork meat, you know, like smoked meat, basically,
yes,
to
yes.
get that, you know, that nice
smoky flavor.
Smoky
yeah.
flavor. Mm-hmm. So, you know, what I've been doing as a vegan is I've been sautéing the collard greens with some garlic, onion, garlic and onion, and, you know, spicing it up. And everyone in my family, they love it, you know, when I do the and coconut.
Peppers.
And
add peppers.
Oil. Oh, peppers?
Add peppers, I'm telling you.
Okay.
Amazing.
And I also do it with coconut oil, too. So it's a way for me to kind of get those healthy fats in there.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
Yeah. So I wanted to give just some nutritional information because, you know, collard greens can be considered like a southern food, and a lot of people, you know, people are talking about how bad soul food is for us and that kind of thing, but this is actually a really healthy soul food. And
people are intimidated by collard greens, by the way.
I don't
so
think
many
they're so delicious. I know, because it's, I think for a lot of people, just in general, it's like a quote-unquote like ethnic food.
I don't know what that's about.
I think it's associated with soul food.
Okay, then, maybe
but,
that's what
you
it
know
is.
You can mix it in with some pasta or whatever, and it's just, it's really, really healthy for you.
Okay, cool.
So the leaves are an excellent source of folates, and which is important in DNA synthesis.
Oh.
And when given during the preconception period, can prevent neural tube defects in babies. Fresh collard leaves are also rich in vitamin C. All right, and let's see, they're rich in vitamin A, and you know, there's so many, you know, it's basically high, very high in antioxidants. I'm naming them. The leafy vegetable contains amazingly high levels of vitamin K. Vitamin K has a potential role in the increase of bone mass by promoting an osteoporotic activity in the bone. So it's also it has beneficial effects for Alzheimer's disease patients by limiting neuronal damage in the brain. Collards are rich in many vitamin B complex groups and calcium, copper, magnesium, and zinc. So,
wow.
Sounds
like a superfood.
I think it is. Like I said, it's like the sister to kale. You have like the mustard greens, collard greens, and it's a leafy green, so you know it's going to be really good for you naturally. And I think that more people should try it out in different ways. And if you're vegetarian or vegan like me, you don't have to always boil and smoke it and all that.
It's stuff. Easily digestible too.
Yes.
Any kind of leafy greens or vegetables are really easy to digest, so it's a really good thing to eat.
And I know
packed full of vitamins.
Absolutely. And I know people who have also used the juice of collard greens for cleanses.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I've heard of that.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard of that.
It's very good for you.
But you have to be careful with collard greens when you're eating them. And you have to eat them within a certain amount of time, because if you keep them in the fridge for a little bit too long, it can make you quite gassy.
Well,
so you have to be careful. There's a fine line with collard greens as opposed to other vegetables. You have to eat them soon.
They do stink.
They will make you gassy if you eat them like 3 days later, you know?
Yeah.
So watch out for that.
I don't even know if it's as short as 3 days. I think when I eat it, just after cooking it, you know.
Really?
Yeah, I just, you know, whatever. I feel like.
I think it's like 3 days is like, oh, no, now I'm in trouble.
No, but it's a great. Do you prepare collard greens at home at all, or?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. Around the holidays.
Do you prepare like the traditional way?
With, onions, mm-hmm. peppers. That's why I said try the peppers, because it's really amazing.
Really?
And with smoked turkey.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Traditional.
Yeah.
Traditional to some, not traditional to all.
Yes. All right. Well, it's that time. It's time for a break. I want to remind our callers to, you know, I want to remind people to call in and join the conversation. 646-929-1521.
Yeah. Share your recipes with us.
That's right. Let's hear how you're working those leftovers.
Yeah. We want to know. We want to know.
All right. You're listening to Food Wrap on the GoPro Radio Network, and we'll be right back.
The views and opinions expressed on GoPro Radio Network shows are solely those of the speakers and are not necessarily the views or opinions of GoPro Radio Networks, Inc. or its affiliates. These broadcasts are provided on the understanding that they do not constitute professional advice or services. Individuals who speak in these broadcasts express their own opinions, experiences, and conclusions. GoPro Radio Networks and its affiliates do not necessarily endorse or oppose any particular opinion or conclusion discussed in these broadcasts. You may not edit, modify, or redistribute these broadcasts in any way without the express permission of GoPro Radio Networks, Inc. GoPro Radio Networks assumes no liability for any of your activities in connection with these broadcasts or for your use of these broadcasts in connection with your website, computer, or playing device.
You're listening to content developed by the GoPro Radio Network, the fastest growing network in the galaxy. GoPro Radio Network. Listen to the voices in your head.
All right, welcome back.
I'm Nina,
and this is Shawna, and we're the host of Food Wrap on the GoPro Radio Network. And if you want to join the conversation, call us at 646-929-1521 mm-hmm. and share your repurposed leftovers with us, because we want to hear what you're doing with your leftovers.
Absolutely. Please call in.
That's right.
We want to hear from you. All right, so what's up next?
Specialty dish.
Ooh.
Fun.
Yeah.
Tasty.
Do you smell it?
Hopefully it's tasty. It smells good.
I hope you like it.
It smells like peppers, and it smells like pasta, and it mm-hmm. smells like cheese, and it smells like garlic.
Mm-hmm. You're close.
Yeah. So specialty dish is when Shawna and I take turns, mm-hmm. and we alternate every week. And this week, it was Shawna's turn to cook something delicious and tasty and amazing for me. Mm-hmm. So I want to know what you prepared for me, and how did you do it?
Okay, so
and hopefully you did it with repurpose food. Let's see.
I did. This is.
Did you really?
This is our Waste Not show, and I take
awesome.
That very seriously. So
I see.
I had some grilled chicken in the refrigerator that I made, and I did something I actually like for myself, and I took the grilled chicken, two pieces of chicken, chopped it up. I got some coconut oil.
Mm.
I threw it in a little like saucepan. Not a saucepan. It's more like a saute pan.
Uh-huh.
And added some onions, garlic, red pepper, yellow pepper.
Yeah, I'm going to have to try this.
And put
while you explain.
And some gluten-free pasta and spinach, because I know you're gluten-free. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that's it. And while Nina's giving this a try, I want to just encourage you guys to go to the website, GoProRadio.com, and click on the donate button so we can continue to bring this great content to you, the listener. We'll take as little as a dollar or as much as, I don't know, sky's the limit. So, Nina, tell us about how it tastes and
it's very delicious. First of all, it's very fragrant. It smells amazing.
Thank you.
I like that the vegetables are not really soggy.
Mm-hmm.
There's a little crunch to them.
Mm-hmm.
The pasta is al dente. Very good.
Thank you.
I mean, everything tastes really good. The chicken is really good. The onions has crunch to it. It has nice flavor. I can taste the garlic. I can taste the onion.
Do you taste the coconut?
I don't taste the coconut.
Okay.
But I think The flavor of coconut in pasta would probably throw me off, so I'm glad I don't taste it.
Oh, good. Okay.
Yeah, but I think it tastes really, really good. Really great job.
Thank you.
Really good job of repurposing leftovers. Now, did you have leftover pasta? Probably. Okay, because you know what? When I make pasta at home, mm-hmm. sometimes I don't use the entire box.
Yeah.
So you can also repurpose those for something like
that. Well, what I did was I actually took like a quarter of a box that I had.
Perfect.
To throw that in there. So I still have some left over for like another meal. But it was the main thing that was left over was the chicken. So I said, okay, what can I do with this chicken so it doesn't go to waste? And this is what I won't put chicken in there, but this is what I would do for like someone else in my household if they wanted, like, this is a great lunch for somebody, or you know, something
and
like that.
You know what I like about this?
What's that?
It's probably under $10 to make something like this. What do you think?
That is absolutely under
$10. I bet
$10.
It's under $10.
It is.
Dinner for 10. Yes. I love that.
I think that's probably more like $5.
Really? That's even better.
Exactly.
That's even better.
You know, it's
and that's a good amount. I mean, look at this. This is a good amount of food.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Yeah.
And it's a lot.
And that took me about 15 minutes to make. It was the longest thing that was the pasta, cooking the pasta. And being that I was gluten-free, this was my first time doing like a gluten-free pasta. So
yeah, it has a good texture. It doesn't mm-hmm. seem any different than any other pasta. So
yeah, really good.
Good stuff.
Thank you.
Good stuff.
Okay, so we got to move on to the next segment. I just want to give out that call-in number again, 646-929-1521. And next up is Food Fight. All right. So what is Food Fight? It's not what it sounds like. basically, Food Fight, Nina and I, you know, one of the things that we both do, we're obsessed with finding articles online about like some treacherous thing some company's doing to destroy us humans. So we research the information, make sure it's accurate, and we bring it to you, the listeners. So Nina, what do you have for us this week?
So being there, we're wasting not this week, and mm-hmm. we're talking about repurposing your leftovers, I decided to basically talk about keeping your leftovers safe to eat.
Okay.
Because that is extremely important if you're going to mm-hmm. repurpose leftovers.
That is very important. I don't know a lot about this, so I'm eager to hear what you have.
I knew a little bit about mm-hmm. this, but I actually learned a couple of things. So I thought it would be really interesting. I actually found quite a few articles about this, mm-hmm. but the one in particular that spoke to me was healthyhousekeeper.com. Mm-hmm. And she talks about, basically, there's a woman who wrote it. And she's saying, here are some key tips. She's basically giving you key tips for safety as far as your leftovers go.
Okay.
Tip number one, savable foods. Now, basically what she's saying is you want to save something that's going to retain its quality. For example, the chicken breast that you use.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's pretty good quality. It's mm-hmm. chicken breast. Mm-hmm. So anyway, when you refrigerate your leftovers, it is important that you begin to store your leftovers about 2 hours after you have cooked it.
Okay.
So actually, to keep it safe, particularly pay attention to dairy and meat products to assure that they're refrigerated promptly after use.
Okay.
So you want to pay attention to those because I believe they decompose pretty quickly, especially dairy.
Okay.
Tip number three, properly storing your leftovers. Even though we are all tempted to wrap everything in aluminum foil,
mm-hmm.
you're better off putting everything in something where there's enough air circulation that's about 1 to 2 inches, like these two containers right here.
Oh,
these are perfect. And, you know, these are nice and small, but you can also have bigger ones. But as long as they're 1 to 2 inches, they're better and the food keeps better in something like this. So
Okay. That's
my example for that. And then refrigerator temperature.
Hmm.
Make sure
that people don't think about.
That's right. Make mm-hmm. sure that your refrigerator is set at 40 degrees, or you can consult your particular refrigerator's reader's manual, because mm-hmm. each refrigerator is slightly different, but 40 degrees is basically where you should have it set.
Okay.
But every refrigerator is different. Some don't say 40 degrees. Some say high, low, medium. So
yeah.
you have to check with your particular reader's manual.
Okay.
The other thing, shelf life.
Mm-hmm.
Tip number four, shelf life. The foremost, okay, this is the problem. People sniff food to feel like, okay, maybe if I sniff it, I can tell.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, I do that and I know I shouldn't. You know, if you're like in doubt of
mm-hmm.
the issue with this particular food, if it's been in there too long, you mm-hmm. should probably just toss it out if you're not sure.
Right. When in doubt, throw it out.
When in doubt, throw it out. And then there's another way of keeping track of your leftovers. For example, if you have something that's been sitting in the fridge later or mm-hmm. for a long period of time, you want to move that to the front and put the new leftovers in the back so that you're rotating and you're doing things in a timely fashion before they decompose.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah. So let me see. Do I have time to do a couple more?
Yes, you do.
Okay.
You have
1 minute. Awesome. Okay, don't eat that. Like, you shouldn't try your leftovers if you're not really sure, which is basically what I said. I think that's it.
Oh, okay.
I think that's it for the leftovers, which I think is really useful, and I'm definitely going to be posting this on our social networks, which I want to share right now, actually, really quickly. Mm-hmm. So we do have a Facebook page, and we post everything that we talk about on our Facebook page, and you can like it, and it's called Food Wrap. Mm-hmm. We share our recipes, everything that we talk about on the shows, and even additional information that we don't talk about on the show. Mm-hmm. So you can like our Facebook page, which is linked to our Twitter, which is Food Wrap Radio.
Yes.
So everything that we post on our Facebook will cross-link to our Twitter account, which is Food Wrap Radio. Mm-hmm. And then we have the Instagram, which you're kind enough to manage, and you post pictures. You did a few minutes ago of us, I believe, and of the specialty dish.
I'm about to do it.
That's right, on Instagram, and which is Food Wrap.
Yep.
And then we have the Pinterest account, which is the Food Wrap Radio Show, and I post the pictures to that, which are like inspirational photographs of different specialty dishes and foods and our guests. And then, of course, we have the YouTube channel.
Uh-oh, you got to hurry because it's time for our next segment.
The Food Wrap Show. Yes. So you want to subscribe to that so you can check out this episode and previous episodes if you've missed them.
Okay.
So
next up
on the menu, we're introducing a new segment just for today.
Woo, woo.
You know what I'm saying? So you can check out what we're going to be doing for 2014.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So.
All right. Next up is.
Dinner for $10.
Woohoo! It's all about saving that change, y'all.
That's what it's all about.
All right. So.
Yeah. So, I mean, basically, what we want to do is we want to have a delicious meal that's inexpensive, healthy. For our viewing audience, our listening audience, because, you know, in this economy, food has become really, really expensive, and we're going to give you some really strategic ways and strategic ideas on how to have a wonderful meal for $10 or less, hopefully.
Yes.
So what do you have?
Okay, so I actually did this myself, so I know it can be done. I know it sounds impossible to buy dinner for $10, but I guarantee you guys can do it. All right, so I'm not going to name the supermarket, but I guarantee you guys can get the same type of savings at any of your local supermarkets. I made meatless baked ziti. Now, if you add meat, it's going to be a little bit more than $10, but I usually make a meatless baked ziti, and everybody loves it, and I'll pair it up with, like, you know, I mean, for me, a lot of times that's all you need. It fills you up. So $3.50 for part skim mozzarella cheese, 16 ounces. $2.29 for part skim ricotta cheese. I know somebody's going to make fun of me for that. 15 ounces. 59 cents. This is, you can always find a pasta on sale. Always. 59 cents for a pasta, and you can use ziti, you can use penne, you can use any pasta
angel
that
hair
you
pasta.
Want. Well, not angel hair pasta, but like any of the short pasta.
Oh, you're talking about for this dish?
Yeah. Yes, for this.
Right.
You can any short pasta you can use, whatever's on sale. $2. For two bottles or two jars of spaghetti sauce, and $1.29 for Parmesan cheese. And basically, you throw those things together, this meal takes less than an hour, and the total amount that I spent on this meal was $9.67.
You just made it under $10.
That's right.
And how much does that feed, would you say?
This feeds about 8 people.
That's
now,
awesome.
I only fed 4 people, but they all had seconds. So, and then there was also leftovers for the next day for lunch. So it's
like
a great
that.
Meal in the middle of the week, something that you need to be quick, easy, and you want something for lunch. That's the meal to do, you know?
Okay.
All right. So Nina, what do you have?
Okay. So I broke mine down a little bit differently from you.
Okay.
I just did a little bit differently. And what I did was I calculated from, you know, I had a staple ingredient, which I didn't include because I always keep olive oil in the house. So I didn't include that in the price. And you can do that with certain things that are, you know, staples.
Mm-hmm.
But what I did was fajita-style quesadillas.
Ooh.
And actually, okay, so I broke it down based on how much I spent per item and how much of it I used.
Okay.
So, for example, if I get 8 ounces of, like, an extra sharp cheddar and it's, like, $2.99, I broke it down in half if I used half a cup of that.
Okay,
so that's
gotcha.
How I did it. So I did For example, the ingredients are very easy.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, really simple ingredients, and it literally takes about 25 minutes to make these quesadilla fajitas. So half a medium green sweet red pepper, mm-hmm. 29 cents.
Mm.
Half a medium onion, 45 cents. A fresh jalapeno, 12 cents. 2 teaspoons of olive oil, and I didn't include that in the price because that's a staple in my household.
Yep.
4 to 6 inch tortillas, $2.89. Half a cup of shredded extra sharp cheddar, $1.25. And I got this cheddar on sale. It's an extra sharp cheddar. Mm-hmm. It's one of my favorites. I'm not going to name it, but it's awesome.
Okay.
2 thin slices of tomatoes, which came to $1.15.
Mm-hmm.
1 tablespoon of chopped fresh cilantro, 25 cents.
Okay.
Based on the amount that I use.
Mm-hmm.
And then sour cream is optional. You can add that. It's only $1.39 in addition.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can use some additional cilantro and lime wedges, you know, as an accompaniment. And my total dinner came to $7.79,
wow.
Which is under $10. So if you want to add pico de gallo, you can add that, and you still will come under $10 still.
That's awesome.
And it literally mm-hmm. takes 20 minutes, and this feeds 8 people.
Or some guacamole.
Mm-hmm. Guacamole. Well, maybe. Yeah, you could probably add the guacamole and still be right at $10, I think.
Yeah.
So that's actually a great idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
that sounds delicious.
Yes.
I can do that minus the cheese. I don't know.
Yeah, you can do it minus the cheese.
Yeah.
You can probably put some potato in there, some mashed potato. That might taste interesting.
I'm gonna have to try that.
Could try that out.
All right. Well, I want to give out the call-in number, and we have to go to a break, 646-929-1521. Next, you know, in our next segment, we're going to be, you know, really talking up how to repurpose that food and, you know, how to waste not.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you're listening to Food Wrap on the GoPro Radio Network, and we'll be right back.
Interrupt this broadcast to bring you a great opportunity. If you have a product or service, a talent or something important to say, now's your chance to have your own radio show. Whether you're just starting out or a veteran looking for a professional platform to enhance your presentation, the GoPro Radio Network is the premier place to cultivate and share new and exciting content. We'll help you to grow your audience and keep it growing long after your first broadcast. Now you have a voice. Call 212-696-8562 today or visit www.goproradio.com, and you'll be amazed at how easy and affordable it is to have your own radio show on the fastest growing network in the galaxy. GoPro Radio. Listen to the voices in your head.
You want to know the truth, folks? Do you really want to know the truth? Well, perhaps you can't handle the truth. But if you can, you can listen to GoPro Radio. Tune in at www.goproradio.com. Now, have I made myself clear?
GoPro Radio Network. Listen to the voices in your head. I know I do.
You're listening to content developed by the GoPro Radio Network, the fastest growing network in the galaxy. GoPro Radio Network. Listen to the voices in your head.
All right, welcome back, guys. So I'm going to encourage you once again to give us a call, because this segment is dedicated to us talking about leftovers, what your leftovers are, what our leftovers are, what our households are like growing up, and all that good stuff. We're going to make sure that we really hammer it in your head. Do not waste food.
Do not waste food. And the reason we don't want you to waste food is because 40% of the American food supply is thrown out. Which is a shame.
And 40%?
40% of our food supply is thrown out. Perfectly good food.
Do you know how many people are starving out there in this very country, not even in other countries?
It's really outrageous. And then mm-hmm. since the 1970s, the amount of food that is wasted has gone up to 50% in the United States.
I wonder what the hunger...
Based on a Reuters article that I found, by the way.
That's very...
It's really outrageous.
I really would like to know what the hunger rate is. Reuters? So we got a little correction. Reuters.
Did I mispronounce? Excuse me. Excuse me. My bad.
So Reuters, not Reuters.
Reuters. Okay.
We're getting cues from our lovely engineer, Ayanna Jones.
My bad.
I'd be curious to know what the hunger rate has been since then, because I know hunger in this country is a huge issue. And as a matter of fact, one of our production assistants, Tatiana, just volunteered at a soup kitchen.
Really?
Not too far from here, up in 70th
Street. Awesome.
Exactly. So, hunger is clearly an issue in this country.
It shouldn't be.
And what really frustrates me is like the number of restaurants,
yes,
and grocery stores and even fast food chains that just throw away food because they do not want to be sued.
Yeah, mm-hmm. rather than donate it, and mm-hmm. I've had conversations with people who have some small businesses, and I'm like, why not just donate that to the homeless? And they're like, oh no, we don't want to be sued if there's an allergic reaction or if mm-hmm. they get sick. And I actually see, right on, what is that street? Columbus Street.
Mm-hmm.
I see homeless people going through bags and picking up bagels and different things. I'm like, really? This is ridiculous. Big bags of food tossed out.
I know.
It makes no sense.
I wanted to talk a little bit. Oh, we have a caller. Wait a minute. We have a caller.
Ooh, awesome.
917.
Hello?
Hi, caller.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
How's everyone?
How is everyone? Who is this lovely person?
This is Nikki.
Hi, Nikki.
Hey, Nikki.
How are you?
Hi, Nikki.
Great. Everyone in the studio says hi.
Hi, everyone in the studio.
Hi. This was one of our guests a few months back.
Yes. And she's a mom.
Yeah.
And she's a stay-at-home mom who has excellent, excellent tips.
And our engineer said, where are her gloves? I just want to remind you.
You know what? I'm staring at them. I'm so pathetic. I need to mail them out. I'm such a slacker. Oh, my goodness. I feel awful. And to make up for that, I'm going to tell you some really good tips that I have for what I do with my leftovers. Because you know that I'm all about saving money and
saving
my food.
Yes. Yes, yes.
Please share.
I have several things that I do with my leftovers. I don't really have like a go-to meal, but I have go-to types of meals. I will do one of six things with my leftovers in no particular order. I will put my leftovers into a salad, a casserole, a one-pot meal, a stir-fry, mm-hmm. a sandwich, or a soup.
Oh.
And I find that, depending on what the food is, it fits better into one thing or the other.
Mm-hmm.
I think soup is the most forgiving because you can throw just about anything that goes well together,
mm-hmm.
and you call it a soup. And if the broth is good and the flavors are good, everyone's going to eat it and they're going to love it. And that's the kind of food we had today.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not what I want to speak about specifically. I'm going to talk about my rotisserie chicken.
Oh,
okay.
Every weekend we go out and, oh my goodness, what are we going to have for dinner? And we pick up a rotisserie chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we cut it up into 8 pieces. The six of us eat, and then there's always that one huge chicken breast that sits in the refrigerator. And on Monday afternoon, I have no idea what to do with my chicken breast, and then, you know what, it has to get used. So what's interesting to do with the chicken is to kind of change it completely. I'm not just going to take it, strip it, and put mayo on some bread and feed it to anybody. They're going to be over the flavor by the next day.
Mm-hmm.
So something fun to do is to completely change the flavor. And I thought it would be nice to share a curry chicken salad recipe with you guys.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. Please, let's go.
Right?
That's awesome.
You think leftovers, and it's like, oh, I'm going to give you guys the same thing we had yesterday. And then the kids are like, oh, I don't want to eat that again.
Yeah, exactly.
So something completely different.
Right.
This recipe is a real simple recipe. It's curry chicken salad.
Mm-hmm.
You basically take the chicken breast and you chop it up into whatever size pieces you like to eat it, bite-sized pieces.
Mm-hmm.
You take two stalks of celery, chop them finely, a quarter cup of chopped green onions, two tablespoons of dill pickle relish, one and a half teaspoons of curry powder, and two tablespoons of mayonnaise. You take everything, you put it into a bowl, mix it together, refrigerate it to really give the flavors a little bit of time to mix well together, and then you slap it on some bread. Voila, your chicken breast is gone.
Oh my God. Can we share that
with our listeners
on our Facebook page?
Absolutely.
Wow. She's giving it up. I love it.
I'm definitely, well, I don't eat
That's
chicken.
A great idea.
I'm definitely going to try that.
That is a great idea.
It's an excellent idea because most people have a chicken salad, but not a curry chicken
salad. Yeah, I like that idea. I'm going to use that idea.
Yeah, that's so much more interesting.
Well, I mean, it's like, you know, you think chicken or tuna salad, and it's always, oh, let me put some mayo on it, and that's it. But there's I mean, there's so much you can do with a salad. You know, there's so many. I mean, there's the flavors out there that you can. The world is the limit, actually. You know, you could put walnuts in it. You can put raisins, cranberries. Mm. There's so many things you can put in salad. In salad or a sandwich, it doesn't just have to be the mayo or the vinegar.
That's a great idea.
So, I love that.
I actually have a question for you because I know you're great with saving money and when you're shopping and all that good stuff. We have a new segment that we're going to be, we just did it today, but we're actually going to be kicking it off in February, and it's dinner for $10. Do you have a meal that you can share with our listeners that they can get for $10 or less?
Yeah, actually, I do. I was just speaking with a friend earlier today about Mexican rice.
Ooh. Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm really big on doing one-pot meals in my house because one-pot meals will stretch your meat.
Mm.
Okay. You can add a ton of vegetables into them, so your family's getting their vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
And because usually my one-pot meals are made with rice, rice stretches. You buy a little bag of rice, and a one-pound bag of rice is usually right around $1, $1.19, $1.20 at the most.
Mm-hmm.
So If you find a recipe for a one-pot meal, you can usually make it for under $10. I buy chicken breasts when they're on sale for $1.99.
That's a great
And with
tip.
One cup of rice, which is less than a dollar, I mean, one cup of rice is half of the bag, so that's 50 cents worth of rice.
Mm.
And a lot of peppers and onions. You can throw peas and carrots in one-pot meals. I mean, you can throw an entire bag of frozen vegetables, and you can actually get it for way less than $10.
Sounds like arroz con pollo. Sounds like arroz con pollo.
Arroz con pollo. Yeah, you know, or I put it in a casserole dish after it's cooked, and I throw some cheese on it and some tortilla and put it in the broiler. And
yummy.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's delicious.
Well, that's a good tip.
Yeah, thank you so much for sharing that, Nikki.
I'll call you guys back with some ideas for $10 meals.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for calling.
Really
great tips. Yeah.
Awesome.
All right, I'll keep listening.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That really great tips. You know, when you're thinking in that realm of like categories, it helps to better organize and even, kind of think about.
I loved her ideas because she gave me some ideas that I haven't used before.
Awesome. I never thought to do curry chicken salad. So, one of the things I wanted to share is that, when I was younger, we lived with my grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
So she's old fashioned. And, you know, I could be a very wasteful child. I'm going to admit it.
Okay. I think all of us are.
When I was growing up.
My children, we don't think about it.
My grandmother was like, because she grew up, her and her children, like my aunts, my uncles, they grew up very poor.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And they had, poor to the point where, okay, sometimes there wasn't a Christmas. So when it came to food, they had to figure it out. There was eight of them, eight kids.
Wow.
And, two adults. So they had to get very creative with their meals. And I remember my grandmother was the queen of leftovers and kind of transforming those leftovers. So a lot of the things that we would have, I remember, well, first of all, I couldn't even approach the garbage with trying to throw something away without hearing, like, what are you doing with that? Where's that? Give me that plate.
I remember those days.
Yeah, so I was not throwing food away. And, some of the things I remember my grandmother making, if we had leftover mashed potatoes, she would throw an egg and some salt and pepper and mix it up and make potato pancakes. Those were the bomb.
Delicious.
Those were the bomb. Loved them.
Delicious. Did you top them with anything?
No.
You just ate them straight up like that?
I put salt. I was a salt freak, so salt
no sugar?
On everything. No sugar.
I'm just checking. Because I know how much you love sugar.
Not that much.
No sugar.
A lot of salt, though. And, a lot of... definitely for my grandfather who, she prepared his lunches. So he had a lot of chicken salad, or things like that. Or roast beef sandwiches. Mm-hmm. Those types of meals.
Yeah.
Or I'm trying to think what else. Another thing she did, she made her own breadcrumbs. So if whatever Italian
That's
bread.
That's a great idea.
That was not used went into
or like
the oven.
The ends.
Yeah, the
ends are perfect.
Those went into the oven to dry out, and then she would grate them up, add some
That's
grated
excellent.
Cheese, and she had breadcrumbs for her chicken cutlets or something like that. So.
Well, guess what? I have an idea for you.
Oh, what's that?
I have a lasagna idea for you, and I know it's been a long time since you've had lasagna.
Don't remind me.
Okay, so basically, leftover mashed potatoes mm-hmm. with that coconut oil spread butter type thing that you've been using lately.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So my idea is with the leftover mashed potatoes, you layer that in the lasagna as if it were the cheese.
Really?
Yeah, you need to try that out. Mm-hmm. Now, when you do your mashed potatoes, you mm-hmm. have to make sure that you crush some garlic and put it in the mashed potatoes mm-hmm. and some onion.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you put it in between the layers of lasagna and you put the sauce over it, tastes phenomenal.
I gotta try that.
You
that
absolutely.
That sounds really good.
It's amazing. And then I also mm-hmm. have another idea, which actually would probably be for meat eaters, but you can actually mm-hmm. do it as well.
Okay.
There always seems to be a lot of leftover white rice at my house or brown rice or whatever
yes.
it is.
Yeah.
Fried rice is a really quick repurposed meal.
How do you do that? Because I'd be interested in trying that out.
Okay, so you throw some sesame oil in the pan.
Mm-hmm.
You chop up some onions like in big chunks. Mm-hmm. You can throw in some scallions. You can throw in some peas, and then you throw in the rice. Oh, you also, before you throw in the rice, you can scramble some eggs or like beat some eggs
yeah.
and throw them in there.
Mm-hmm.
Throw in the rice, cook it on a really high heat, add some peas, serve it up.
That's
you can add
good.
Chicken to it. You can add shrimp to it or no vegetables
mm-hmm.
or even tofu. But then again, that would be good for a vegetarian. You would have to eliminate the egg.
Yeah, which most of the time, like when I go to a Chinese restaurant, I don't get, like, I'll get fried rice with no meat or no egg in it.
Soy sauce, by the way. I forgot about the soy sauce. You have to add soy sauce to it.
Mm.
Yeah, and you have to, of course, when you're sauteing the vegetables, you mm-hmm. can't saute them for too long. You got to do it really quickly.
Really quick.
This really cooks in about 5 minutes because you want the vegetables to be nice and crispy.
How do you get that brownish? You know how, like, the fried rice you get in the Chinese
soy
restaurant?
Soy sauce and sesame oil.
Oh,
yes.
Awesome. I'm definitely trying that out. Thank you.
You can.
For that.
You can.
All right. It's time for a break. We're way over time for our break.
We're having too much fun.
9:46. All right. You're listening to Food Rep on the GoPro Radio Network, and we'll be right back.
You want to know the truth, folks? Do you really want to know the truth? Well, perhaps you can't handle the truth. But if you can, you can listen to GoPro Radio. Tune in at www.goproradio.com. Now, have I made myself clear?
GoPro Radio Network. Listen to the voices in your head. I know I do.
You're listening to content developed by the GoPro Radio Network, the fastest growing network in the galaxy. GoPro Radio Network. Listen to the voices in your head.
All right, we're back.
And this is Shawna Glover, and I'm Nina Marcalle, and we're the hosts of Food Wrap on the GoPro Radio Network. And
our
talk
never tasted so good.
You know what I'm saying? And you need to give us a call and share some of your repurposed leftovers with us.
I know.
At 646-929-1521. That's 646-929-1521. And you can also, if you want to contact us, actually, I forgot to talk about this, and I want to bring it up now. We're gonna be having quite a few chefs on this year, which is part of the new stuff that we're doing this year at Food Wrap.
Mm-hmm.
We're really excited about that. And we're actually gonna have someone on next week.
Yes, very talented young man.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And if there are any of you that are chefs and want to be on the show,
mm-hmm.
you can contact us on our Food Wrap Facebook page and send us an email if you want to be a guest on the show. You can also call us at 646-929-1521. And it seems like we have
a caller.
How awesome.
404 caller, you're on the air.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are
Hello,
you?
Hello, how are you?
Michael.
Hi, Michael, how are you?
Hi, Michael, how are you?
So, can
Not
you...
Not bad.
Sorry, go ahead.
I'm calling from the Bronx, and
the boogie
you know,
down.
I had a question about the comment. About with the leftovers with the lasagna and the mashed potatoes. It sounds like it's a really good idea, but do you think that would have a lot of carbs, like maybe too many carbs?
Well, I mean, if you're watching your carbs, obviously you don't want to do it, but there are plenty of people who are not watching their carbs. Like if you're watching your carbs, I mean, and if you have maybe a cheat day, you can do it on a cheat day. But as far as I'm concerned, if you have a cheat, do you have a cheat day? Obviously, you're watching your carbs, right? You're speaking for yourself?
Yes.
Okay, so.
I'm speaking for myself, correct.
Do you ever have a cheat day?
I do. Just, sometimes I kind of reserve those days for like real, like junk food, like
that's like hilarious.
And pizza, you know, and
you like, can reserve it for the potato lasagna, dude. You really can, because it's so delicious.
It sounds good. It really does sound good. And I think that's one that I'm going to try. I'm going to go ahead and try. Thanks for the idea.
Well, we'll post the recipe too.
I will post the recipe because it's my recipe and it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing.
Do you have any leftovers? Do you have any? I'm sorry, do you have any leftovers that you might a go-to that you might use?
Or that you repurpose?
You know, I do a lot. What I'd like to do is mix a lot of foods. I try to put in like vegetables with the rice, you know, just to try to, you know, make the food more. But you know, I don't have any special leftover recipes. You know, in my house, my mom, she calls it contrivance.
That's funny.
She takes a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and she really, whenever, you know, she was a whiz at leftovers. I'm one of five kids. There's like five of us here. Mm-hmm. And, you know, she would make gourmet leftovers.
Ooh.
And, you know, I could never make as good as contrivance as she could.
I like that, contrivance. That's a very cool name.
That's pretty nice.
Well, thank you so much for calling in and sharing your, you know, story with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for calling in.
Well, thank you for the show. You guys, I listen to you guys every week, you know, thank you for doing this. It's a really informative program that you guys have.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. That means a lot. We really appreciate you listening and tuning in.
That's right.
All right, Michael. Thank you so much. Michael from the Bronx.
Michael from the Boogie Down.
Yeah.
The Boogie Down.
So, Nina, what was your household like in terms of leftovers? I know your mom was like on point when it came to the food.
She was on point. I mean, most of the time we basically ate the leftovers, like as they were. It was
okay.
She didn't really repurpose anything.
Okay.
You know, but I definitely was a child until the age of 11. I really wasn't really into food. I was into vegetables, but as far as meat and things, I used to dump things. That, I mean, I feel terrible about it now, but I used to throw things in the garbage.
Chicken bones behind radiators.
Chicken bones behind radiators. I told you that story. I would dump stuff out of the window, flush stuff down the toilet, and she'd be like, ah! She'd be yelling at me.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So I realize now that, of course, that was just me being a bratty kid, not wanting to eat my food to do it. All I wanted to do was play all the time. All I wanted to do was play all the time. And a lot of children are like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, you have to teach your children values when they're really young and explain to them, you know, you really shouldn't be doing that, you know?
Yeah, because I think the kids nowadays, I know even my own kids, you know, in this day and age are, you know, unfortunately very wasteful. They don't make the connection. They're not thinking about it. It's like, oh, I don't want that. That doesn't taste good. Mm-hmm. And they'll throw away something in a second. And a lot of times I have to catch my own kids like, why are you throwing that away? I don't know. It's like, you know, they just don't get it. And I don't think they will get it until they have families of their own and they have to budget food and, you know.
I don't have that issue at my house.
Spend those hours cooking.
I don't have that issue at my house. Like, everybody at my house is, like, so excited for leftovers. So it's like, you know, I guess you have to instill the values in them when they're really, really young. Mm-hmm. And eventually it'll click.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I mean, I do talk to them, but I don't know. It hasn't clicked yet. I don't know. But, And another thing I remember during Thanksgiving, real quick, because I know we're coming to the end of the show, but during Thanksgiving, it was kind of like I spent it at my mother's house, and my aunt was there and a bunch of family members. And so the next day, we had to figure out what to do with all this food, and they made turkey soup. They took the stuffing. They added flavors. They repurposed that stuffing. And we had like a whole new Thanksgiving meal the very next day. So
what about turkey sandwiches?
Turkey sandwiches.
What about turkey soup?
They had sweet potato. They did some stuff.
What about turkey pot pie?
That's a good idea.
I've done that. I haven't done it in quite a few years, but turkey pot pie is so easy. You just get some pastry shells and you throw the turkey in there with some of that gravy, that leftover gravy, and you throw some vegetables in there. You bake it. Turkey pot pie.
That's a good idea. The only time I've had pot pies were in school, and they were probably not good for us back then.
No.
This is a lot of MSG.
This is a better turkey pot pie, I'm telling you.
That sounds
really tasty.
Delicious. Mm-hmm. So there you go, guys. Another idea, turkey pot pie. All right. So we're coming to the end of our show. Oh, I just hit the mic. Sorry. We're coming. Sorry. I gotta stop hitting the mic. So we're coming to the end of the show. So, Nina. Are you ending or am I ending?
You are ending, young lady.
All right. So we like to thank. I don't know where my notes are. Sorry. Okay, we like to thank you for joining us today. So next up on next week's menu, we have we have a very special chef coming
yes.
in. He's awesome. He's phenomenal. I can't wait to talk to him.
Me neither.
He's the urban foodie Isaiah Kelsey. And you guys make sure you tune in for that show because it's going to be a real treat. We got to thank our producer, Tylan Eusebio Washington, our lovely engineer, Miss Ayana Jones. We have our technical engineer, online engineer, Mohammed El Safdi, and our production assistants, Tatiana Washington and Tiana Washington. Thank you so much for tuning in to Food Wrap on the GoPro Radio Network.
The sexy part of the show is up next.
It is.
And check it out.
Make sure you tune in for that. We'll talk to you next week.
Peace out.
Is you looking for good eating? Then stay beat in the path to the network with the best. Rap will hook you up fast. They keep it crispy with the 411 and eating you right. Chopping it up, dishing it out. It's tasting good, but don't bite. With recipes are sublime and info fresh off the vine. They keep you GMO free because be you all what you eat. Now if you too busy chewing on the FAT fat whack, tune into the F to the O to the O to D food rap. Listen to the kitchen on the show with the utmost. With Nina, me and Shawna G, your fly MC chef host.
Food rap.
It's time to eat better. I know you feel the pressure. Can I get a yes, yes, sir? A yes, yes, sir. For the hot show on the block, from the street to the hood. Keep it locked. Bump and rap and talk. Never tasted so good.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio. Goodbye.